Joe Biden is making a big play for supporters of his former fellow candidates, turned endorsers, Pete Buttigieg, Amy Klobuchar, Beto O'Rourke. But he's also getting support from some more unlikely sources who are actually crossing party lines. Conservative Republican Matt Lewis tweeting this morning that he is casting a primary vote for Joe Biden, adding to fellow Republicans, you should too, and saying this isn't Operation Chaos, it's Operation Normalcy. Lewis laying out why he's crossing party lines in his Daily Beast piece. This Virginia conservative Republican is riding with Biden. Matt Lewis is with me now. And so, have you, as a conservative Republican, have you held your nose and voted Democrat today, Matt?
Yes, I have. I voted this afternoon.
How did it feel?
It felt surprisingly good. It was weird. I've never voted in a Democratic primary before. First time for everything. But it felt good because I'm confident that this was the right move. As a conservative, it was the right move.
Why did you do it?
Well, look, I think that the worst possible scenario is we get to November and you have Donald Trump, who's a right-wing nationalist, against Bernie Sanders, a socialist. And those are your two choices, a nationalist versus a socialist. I can't stop Donald Trump now. He's not, you can't beat him in a primary. We tried that 4 years ago. But what you can do is stop Bernie Sanders. There is a guy named Joe Biden, who I think is by far the most conservative, who has a chance to win. There's a thing called the Buckley Rule that Bill Buckley used to tell people to do. It was for a general election, admittedly. Vote for the most conservative candidate who had a chance to win. I actually think that today the most conservative candidate with a chance to win is Joe Biden.
So was this just your warm-up in voting Democrat? I mean, for the people watching, they're wondering, what are you doing in November?
Yeah, that's a very good question, Brooke. And I tell you, it's probably an unsatisfying answer for Democrats who are liking me today. I probably won't vote at all. And the reason is I actually view primaries differently. And some people will say this is inconsistent. But in my mind, what I did today was a vote of conscience to stop Bernie Sanders. A guy who has been an apologist for, communist, socialist regimes that committed atrocities, that had gulags, that committed human rights abuses. I'm helping stop Bernie Sanders today. That's different from voting in November,
Matt,
for a Democrat who would advocate things that I don't agree with.
It is totally inconsistent. I mean, explain how you're able to then put aside your Republican values today, like, right to life, and vote for a Democrat in the primary, yet somehow that's okay with you on Super Tuesday, but you can't do that in the general election.
It's a tough one, Brooke. Admittedly, this is something I wrestled with. I really went back and forth. Is this the right thing for me to do? Am I meddling in their campaign, and if I vote in the primary, am I then compelled to vote in the general? I think today is about stopping Bernie Sanders, someone that I can sleep well tonight knowing that I tried to do that. In November, I don't view that as a lesser of two evils binary choice. I view my vote in November as an endorsement of somebody. And as somebody who's pro-life, I don't think I'm gonna feel comfortable in November voting for Joe Biden, someone who's administration would pursue an agenda that I don't agree with.
But given all of the articles, I just have to push you on this.
Okay.
All of the times we've talked on TV about how much you have criticized Donald Trump. If you sit out in November and let the other guys, sit at home and hope for the best, how can you still exercise your vote or your voice in speaking up and criticizing the president if you don't vote?
Well, luckily for me, I have a column. I have Twitter. I have my CNN appearances. But most, I get it. Most people don't have that
luxury,
sort of privileged to have that outlet. So it's a little bit unfair for me to say that. Good for me, but not for thee. Look, this was just a really, really tough choice. I think that voting in November is more of an endorsement. I did not vote in 2016, and I continued to criticize Donald Trump when he deserved it for the last 4 years. That was a tough decision I made, but I decided I could not in good conscience vote for Hillary based on ideology, based on the fact that I profoundly disagree with her agenda philosophically.
I got you.
But
I couldn't
vote for Trump because of character and a lot of other stuff.
Okay. Well, congratulations today. I say that in jest, Matt Lewis. It's a totally interesting position you're in. I'm sure it was. Matt Lewis, always appreciate hearing your perspective and your side of things. Thank you very much.